On this week's weekly video fishing forecast, Fisherman senior editor Fred Gallofaro talks about getting away from the lockdown state of New York and fishing the Florida Keys. I'll have some details on freshwater action and a teaser tying how-to video, and a Montauk report from Timothy O'Rourke, plus a freshwater report from Paul McCain, all here at thenewfisherman.com.
The Fishing News is sponsored by these fine partners.
News 12 meteorologist Rich Von Olin let me know this weekend's weather could be favorable for cod boats to hit the wrecks, with Sunday being the better day with 2 to 4 foot seas. Remember, be sure to check out News 12 for the latest weather before you head out on the water. Fisherman senior editor Fred Gallofaro has much experience fishing the Keys. Don't let the pandemic put a damper on going south. Florida is open and it's safe to fly.
Hey, thanks, Matt. And not a whole lot going on the fishing front, as you'd expect, with the weather we've been having. There is some ice fishing, thanks to the cold. You always have the trout in Connecticut River State Park, and the tidal creeks and rivers like the Connecticut and Carmans have been producing some white perch, and also winter over striped bass, quite a few of them, in fact. I don't know about you, but I know I've about had it with the cold, snow, and ice, and it has me thinking more along the lines of places like the Florida Keys. I know a lot of folks normally this time of the year are headed for more exotic destinations out of the country, but with COVID travel restrictions, it's not very practical. Domestic travel is less cumbersome and very doable. I know a lot of people have been flying. Florida Keys are easy to get to. You can fly out of MacArthur Airport right into Fort Lauderdale. And it's an hour and a half, hour and 45-minute drive to Isle of Rod in the heart of the Keys. If you're on a budget, it's great to charter a boat, to hire a guide, and by all means, if you can afford to do that, do it. It's a great experience. But if you're on a budget, you can also do a lot of fishing from shore. There are a lot of great opportunities along Route 1, the shoreline all along Route 1, all around the bridges. There's numerous bridges strung throughout the Keys. All hold fish at the bridges. You have a good shot at tarpon, snook. I've caught permit. We've caught Kubera snapper, grouper, jack crevalles around the bridges. So you do have a lot of options there. You can wade flats, roadside flats, and give you a shot at bonefish, permit, and barracuda all along those shorelines also. Tackle's pretty simple. I mean, pack a couple of rods, a 6.5 foot light action rod, and maybe a little heavier, 7.5 foot. It should cover most of the bases. Make them two piece, or better yet, travel rods that break into three pieces. Tsunami, by the way, makes some good quality but affordable travel rods. You might want to check them out. And then, as far as fishing news down there, the Stanix over at Bud and Mary's. It's budandmarys.com, and that's N instead of A-N-D. They're a great source for Florida Keys info, and they can set you up with accommodations and charters and guides. They also have fishing videos and reports on their website, so you can give you a heads up on what's going on down there currently. Captain Bruce Anderson, he runs the Captain Easy out of Isle Mirada. I know a lot of folks from Long Island have fished with him. I've gotten a lot of good feedback from those people. So if you're looking especially for an offshore or reef charter, he's a good guy to look up, and you can contact him at the number below. Matt, back to you.
Let me end that JetBlue has a nonstop to Key West from JFK. Wheels up at 10 a.m., line in by 2 p.m. With the little thaw we've had, I found some open water on a couple of the local ponds nearby. And even better, some fish willing to cooperate too. So finally, some of the ice melted in that allowed me to find some open water on the lakes on Long Island. And the fishing's been pretty good. There's a lot of holdover brown trout still on the lakes. So I've been using either the fly rod, using an olive woolly bugger, that's been working pretty good. And if you want to try the spinning rod, you could try a small gold Castmaster. Either way, the fish are very aggressive. The water's starting to warm up a little bit. Should have warm temperatures this whole week. Like I said, we did get a good string of ice fishing last week, but that ice is melting. There's unsafe ice and there is open water now. So I got out here in the little tin boat. I'm finding some trout. It's been really good fishing. I suggest you go try it for yourself.
Our Montauk Report comes this week from upstate New York with Captain Timothy O'Rourke.
Well, thanks, Matt. Well, as you can see, I'm not in Montauk this week. But I do have a report that's really nothing to talk about. last Saturday, the Viking went out cod fishing. Unfortunately, the weather didn't cooperate all that well. Fishing was pretty slow. Most of the fish caught were all shorts, and they didn't even end up with any keepers. That's pretty much par for the course this time of year, but you got to compliment them for trying. They'll be going again this Saturday and Sunday, weather permitting. And, you know, it's been one of those things when it's either slow or it's really good when they get out there. So hopefully this weekend we'll have a better report. As you can see, I've opted to go skiing instead of think about fishing. So make sure you get out and enjoy the weekend, and everybody have a good trip. All right, see ya.
With our flying freshwater report, we have Paul McCain from River Bay Outfitters.
Hello, Matt. Well, here we are, right again, another week of ice and snow. The opportunities for fly fishing are getting slimmer. There are, the parks are open. The Connectquod is open. You can go up to the Croton if you want. Go fish the tidal creeks for some white perch. I understand they're still around. There is opportunities. Myself, I don't want to waste time looking for opportunities here on Long Island during the fishing season. So that's what I've been doing. I've been scouting. Here I am out in Sears Bellows County Park. I'll be running a trip out through the shop out here. It's a great opportunity. Kettle ponds loaded with bass and bluegills and crappie and pickerel. It should be an excellent time. So this is the time of year. Do your exploring. Check out fresh and salt. Look for the opportunities that you have here on Long Island. We got many. And get out there and check it out. Or you could go home and tie flies, or you could sit on the couch and watch some fish and videos. I'm not going to waste my time. I don't want to waste my time during the fishing season. So get out there right now if you can. Tie lines, everybody, and I'll see you next week, Matt.
With more snow underway, is the perfect time to tie teasers for the upcoming season. It's pretty simple. All you need is a vise, bobbin, good clippers, material for the fly, and epoxy for the finishing touches. Let's take a look on how Andrea ties his version of a Sandeel teaser.
So today I'm going to show you how to tie a simple Sandeel, like baitfish teaser or fly. It's made up of pretty simple materials, using a hackle feather and white and chartreuse. I'm going to add a little bit of lateral flash and some ostrich hurl. So, show you. So you start by wrapping your thread onto the hook shank. Okay. Cut away the tag end. Then I'm gonna start with white on the bottom, is like the belly. The hackle feathers, there's like a brittle part, so I usually cut that off to make it more durable. So let's tie that in there. I like to measure out the feathers, make sure they're the right lengths too, to have like a uniform profile. When you get pretty good at this, or you can start to use, so just one feather at a time, you can start doing like two. So that's what I'm gonna do here. Measure that. Take my chartreuse tackle and put that on top of the white. Start adding my flash. The flash, I like this type of flash. I like to measure it out as like almost the length of the fly or the teaser. So and I only use a couple strands. Maybe I use three here. Three on each side of the teaser. You want it to go like down the side, because it's going to be a lateral line, so laterally of the fly. Your flash on there, and then this is like an added part. Ostrich Hurl just gives it a better look and profile, because it adds like a darker like top to the teasers or the flies, and that's what most bait fish are like. So I'm gonna do a couple strands. Okay, and I put that right on the top. Okay, so that's all the material part. So now you're just gonna start building the thread. You know, you want everything covered. Okay. All right, and to finish it off, I'm just gonna whip finish it with the whip finishing tool. So you just do that. A couple of times. That's it. It's a real simple pattern. If you want, you could add eyes to it and then epoxy over. Makes it look even better. But I just fish it just like that and catch all kinds of stuff from schoolies, bluefish, weakfish, and fluke. So you could put eyes on it or leave it without eyes. Either way, it's a easy and simple profile. Very easy to tie. So if you want to give it a shot, try it for yourself.
Go see Paul at River Bay Outfitters. He should have everything you need to get started. The Fisherman Magazine is giving away a Circle Hook sample pack of Gamagatsu hooks, fish bites, and a gator, all for subscribing or renewing your subscription. Act now while supplies last. Remember to like our video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and tap on the bell to be notified instantly when we post a new video on YouTube. Check out this week's description on YouTube for all the related links and information. The March issue of Fisherman is out next week, and we'll have a preview. Stay warm and see you next Thursday right here at theallnewfisherman.com.
Steigercraft boats, built by people who fish our waters. Serious Anglers choose Steigercraft for their 40 years of boat building experience right here in the Northeast and Mid-Atlantic. Visit Steigercraft.com for a dealer near you.